Todd here today with the Thompson brothers, Miles, Lyle, and Jerome. Yes, please tell us a little bit about how you decided where you wanted to go to college and your recruiting process.
So for me and Miles, it was we made the decision together, and we obviously, you know, took advice from my father and my brothers. But we both wanted to go to a school where we were able to play the game the way we wanted to play the game, and basically just to have fun. We wanted to go to a school that we would enjoy playing the game of lacrosse. We didn't want to go to a school where we were stuck in a system or anything like that. And we seen Albany, you know, they were really freelance, a lot of freedom. But the best thing about it was just, you know, the way Coach Marr was, our connection with Coach Marr and at the time Coach Ralph. Our options came down to basically Syracuse and Albany. And came down to Albany. We knew the style of play that they had at Albany, and a lot of people questioned, you're going to a school that's not going to win a championship and that's not going to really win anything. A lot of people told us before we went there, but we looked at it as an opportunity, to change a program, to make a program better, and we become the best we can be, and you know, hopefully, you know, we got a chance to change the whole school program around.
All right, so Jerome, you played at Onondaga. Can you tell us a little bit about your experience there?
Me and my older brother, we were heavily recruited coming out of high school. We had got letters from Maryland, Hopkins, and all those big schools, but we didn't have good enough grades. And we started learning English pretty late, so we're kind of like held up in that department. But so we chose Onondaga Community College to try to up our GPA and so that we can go to Syracuse. Our dream was, as kids, were always to play there, because a lot of the people we looked up to had gone on to Syracuse and played there, so that's something that we've always looked up to and we wanted to do. So we went to Onondaga Community College and tried to get our grades up, and Jeremy, my older brother, he ended up getting into Syracuse.
Can you guys tell me about one of your favorite moments about playing college lacrosse?
You know, one of my favorite moments of playing at college lacrosse was just to play alongside my brother. You know, that's something that we grew up doing, and, you know, we decided we wanted to go to college together. You know, one memory that sticks out the best is my senior year, we played Stony Brook, and it was the championship game in American East, and our season could end. And we were down by 2 goals with like probably 2 minutes left. And we call timeout. Coach says we need this game. He comes up to Lyle, he's like, Lyle, what do you want to do? He's like, I'll take the ball. He scored the game tying. And then after we won the faceoff, we come down, he gets the ball, and he gets the game winning assist. And that memory was like, it stuck out to me because it could have ended our season right there, and then we ended up going on and we made it to the quarterfinals.
Yeah, play Notre Dame.
For me, it was probably, I don't know, probably just sharing the Toronto Award with him. Just that experience being down there, and you could see, you know, how much of a joy it was for me and in our speech, and it was just an unforgettable experience for me, that award ceremony.
For me, my most memorable moment was probably winning our second JUCO championship, national championship, and to top that all off, I won the JUCO Player of the Year, so it's just a great experience and great time there.
So, do you guys have any advice for kids that are trying to, in middle school and high school, that are trying to go on and play at the next level in college?
You know, I always share my experiences and what I've gone through, just because it's a way for other people to learn. I watched my brothers go through everything, and I took a note from each one of them. You know, Jeremy, he went through college. He went through high school, struggled with high school, and in high school he struggled with drugs, alcohol. It was something he struggled with, but he battled his way through. He worked hard to get through that, and I think he taught us all a lesson. You know, we've never touched a drug or had a sip of alcohol in our lives. You know, for my story, it's just hit in the books. You know, everyone's going to tell you that. Everyone's going to tell you that you need to hit the books. You need to do what you need to do to get on. Don't do what you need to do just to get on the field. Do what you need to do to get into a college. And that's something I guess I knew because my brothers went through. But, you know, I worked hard and to get my SAT score and my ACT scores up to get into school. And it was a learning lesson for me. Once I got into college, I think I worked a lot harder. As far as academically, I tell you the same thing I tell every single kid at a camp or anyone who asks for advice, and that's just keep your stick in your hand and keep your ears open to learn. Always be willing to learn, whether it's from your mother, your father that have never played the game of lacrosse, no, they don't know too much about the game. If they see something in you, you know, take that as, you know, they see something in you. They take it as a learning experience. And for me, just keeping my stick in my hand is what got me to where everywhere I've been. I've been around the world, you know, teaching the game, playing the game. And, you know, it's what I love to do. It's what I'm passionate about is playing the game of lacrosse. So.
And we have this story in our ways that tells us that an animal story that played the game before us. And the moral of the story with the different animals was there's different animals on the field that bring different perspective to the game. And I see myself as the bear. And, you know, I'm not really the fastest. I've never been the fastest lacrosse player out there. But, you know, I'm good with my hands. So that's something that I always worked with. I always had good hands. But I wanted to take my game to the next level, and I started working out. I lost weight, and I tried to get faster. You know, I'm still not the fastest attackman out there, but, you know, I got a little bit faster by losing weight.
It's gotten him better.
Getting the weights involved.
For me, it's just, the best thing is just be a coachable player. I mean, that's what a lot of coaches look for in lacrosse players these days, is someone who can be told what to do or just be that coachable player.
All right, can you guys tell me who's the toughest player you've had to play against in either college or in the MLL or NLL?
Mine is definitely Tucker Durkin. Went up against him my sophomore year and I think my junior year too in college, and now he's on the Florida Lions. Fortunately, he's on the same team as me now. So he was someone that's just, you know, a really athletic guy, aggressive guy, but at the same time, you know, he uses his brain and he's a smart defender. Stays in front of you, but at the same time stays on you.
I never really matched up against the same defender like he did. But I would just say, I don't know, a defender that played man-to-man on me and didn't watch what was going on, because I'm more of a player that likes to backdoor defenders. So if he's watching me the whole time, I really can't get open. I like to move off the ball. I'm not really a one-on-one type of guy. So I don't know, I usually didn't get one defender on me.
Me is probably Sid Smith. He plays for Rochester. And I played with him at Onondaga one year, and I mean, just going up against him in practice, that was tough too. But I mean, playing against him in the pros, he's a really good, aggressive defender, and you know, just tough to go up against.
All right, thank you guys so much for taking time to do the interviews.
Yeah, thank you.
No problem, man. Thank you for having me.